Hello and welcome to the Sunshine Parenting Podcast, where each week we talk about ideas for raising kids who become thriving adults. I'm your host, Audrey Monkey. I'm a summer camp director, writer, and speaker, and I've had the privilege of working with thousands of children, teenagers, young adult counselors, and parents over the past three decades. My husband, Steve, and I are raising five kids who currently range in age from 15 to 25. So my interest in raising kind, optimistic, self-reliant kids who become thriving adults is personal as well as professional. If you've been listening to the Sunshine Parenting Podcast for a while, you might remember from back in episode 36 when I talked to Kelly Pietrangeli from Project Me. Well, she's back for this episode, episode 67, and we're talking about a fun new opportunity for 2019 called Project We. I hope you enjoy this episode. Well, hi, Kelly. Welcome back on the podcast.
Thanks so much for having me back.
Why don't you introduce yourself again, just for any listeners who missed our last episode, which I will for sure link to in the show notes.
Sure. Well, I'm Kelly Pietrangeli, and I'm the creator of MyProjectMe.com. And MyProjectMe is really a hub of tools and inspiration and resources to help you live a more well-balanced life. So I launched that in 2013, and it's been growing ever since. And it's been helping. I created my Project Me for myself over 10 years ago. And it was always meant to be something that was just my own project for me to start to get my messy life into a sense of order. And then once I got my life into order, I decided it was really a framework that I could put out to help other women as well. And my book goes through the framework, and you can explore the website. And yeah.
I just love it. And I also just love the colors on it. It's like I go to your website or I pick up your book, and it's just, it's all the like the bright colors. It just makes you feel happy just even looking at the book and your website. And I love your weekly emails too. They're always really positive and uplifting. And there are very few kind of email lists that I get and actually read each week. And yours is one of them.
That's so great to hear. Thank you, Audrey.
Anyway, so it's so much fun. So I'm so excited. We had so much fun chatting and getting to know each other last time, and we have stayed in touch and are just loving following each other's projects and everything. So this is just so much fun. But you have a really great new project that you're launching in 2019. So why don't you tell listeners about that?
I'd love to. Well, Project We, so it's going from Project Me, we're flipping the M to make it a W. Project We is going to be a membership community of women from all over the world who are working on our Project Me's together, because together we lift each other higher.
Yeah.
It is, you know, I didn't get to tell you in the last interview that back when I started my Project Me, like I said, over 10 years ago, I wasn't doing it alone. I got together with two girlfriends, and they didn't yet know each other, but I knew they were both kind of growth mindset, like-minded women. And we began getting together once a month with the sole purpose of working on our lives, like just checking in and seeing which areas of our life where we're feeling out of balance, where we might need some action steps and what habits we wanted to break and all of that. And in the beginning, we didn't really have a framework for how we were doing it. We just met up once a month and we sort of talked about our lives. But after a while, it developed kind of like a fine wine. It developed over time, and we got a structure to it. And we decided to divide the time we had together, divided up by three. So each of us had the same amount of time where we had the floor. So when it's your turn to talk, you're just talking and the others can, you know, add something, but no one's chiming in and going, oh, I know how you feel. I've done that too. It doesn't go to their life. It's just the spotlight's on you for that time. And it's those monthly meetups that made us all, our Project Me's just blossomed into these amazing things for all three of us. And we are this month celebrating our 10-year anniversary of having our monthly meetups. And for a while, I moved to Madrid, and suddenly the first thing I thought of was not schools for my kids or, you know, where are we going to live? I was like, what am I going to do without my power posse.
Oh, I love that. That's so, what you call it, your power posse. That's so good.
Yeah, well, they're, like, it's my power posse, power. My Project Me power posse. Yes. Yeah, exactly. And so with the magic of Google Hangouts, we carried on. And then Anna, she moved to Singapore. And so we had the time zone difference to deal with. And we just carried on. And we really never missed a session because we know that it helps us so much to stay on top of our little mini goals in our life areas, as well as our bigger goals, and for that accountability and that support. And so it's been interesting for me because I realize that here I am promoting something, Project Me, which is checking in with yourself once a month and seeing where you're in and out of balance and all the tools and all the strategies I teach. But the missing element for people is not necessarily having growth mindset, like-minded women to be able to do this with. And I began hearing this from women over and over again who would hear about my power posse and said, I don't really have anybody in my life that I can do this with. And it made me feel really sad. And I thought, gosh, I really feel blessed to have what I have. And so that is what set the wheels in motion for creating Project We. Oh, so Project We is going to be this, it's going to be a couple of different elements to it. One is a password protected members area where you go into and you have got in your 8 key life areas, all these little mini courses that you can unlock and you can begin working on. If you've marked yourself low in the family area of your life, you could go in there and you could see resources and some videos and things to help you to make things better in the family area of your life. And the same with all of the other life areas, your health and your work and, you know, all of that. And in addition to this kind of hub of tools and inspiration, which will just keep growing as time goes on, there's also the membership community, the Project We community. And that is where you are going to be meeting all of the other women who are working on their Project Me. And I'm going to be setting everybody little challenges, and we're going to have, you know, every Monday, Motivation Monday, what are your goals for the week ahead? And, you know, a check-in at the weekend to celebrate your wins, because we don't do that often enough. Sometimes we feel like we're tooting our own horn if we were to say to a friend, oh my gosh, I feel really proud of myself because this happened. They would be like, okay, which is sad because I think your friends should really support you, but you know what I mean. And in this space that I'm creating, it's going to be like toot your own horn all you want, celebrate your wins and share what's going great in your life, and also share what's not going so great so that we can support you.
Oh, that just sounds so fabulous, Kelly, and so what people need right now. I think, you know, they say that loneliness and isolation are kind of the biggest issues that people have now, and we're so much better together. Like, I get better. Like, when I share with a friend an idea, we both are encouraged and get better. So I was talking to you before we started recording, I was sharing with you that just probably about 2 months ago, I have a friend, Anne, who I meet. We meet at Cycle Bar. We meet at Cycle Bar and then we get coffee afterwards. And we've been doing it consistently weekly since June. And she is a business owner. She runs a bookstore. And I am launching a book in 2019. And so we decided to, as part of our coffee dates, to kind of set goals and check in with each other about how we're doing. And it's been so great because same thing, we take turns. I'm going to start the timer idea because I like that, adding that element, but we take turns and it's checking in. We ask each other questions. So how did that go with, you know, whatever you were doing? And it's so good. Now this is mostly like business related, and I love just this. It has been so good because when I know I'm meeting with her, I'm like, oh, I said I was going to get this list together of people that I'm going to contact or whatever my to-do was. It's like I have a deadline. And I know you listen to Gretchen Rubin and follow the four tendencies, but since most of us are obligers, we need that accountability. We need somebody, or like kind of a deadline, somebody to say, hey, I'm going to ask you about this next week. How are you doing on that goal or that action that you said you were going to do? So I love this. I'm wondering, with Project We, is there going to be an opportunity for people to maybe find people like in their area to connect with live? Is there going to be any of that?
You know, it's one of these things that's going to be evolving as time goes on. So in the beginning, I've got something called founder membership, and that's going to be a really low entry monthly fee. It's going to be kind of like, Netflix for your life, you know. You know, you pay a monthly membership fee, but what I'm doing for founder members is freezing that price, and they will never pay more. So when everything grows and expands and turns into, you know, its full fruition, they're still going to be at the founder's rate forever locked in. So I'm excited about that. And the other thing that's great about founder membership is that this is what we're going to be doing, figuring out what do people want? How can we evolve this more? And, you know, we'll take it as it comes kind of thing. But at the beginning, it's going to be very much about a little doing the life wheel check-in once a month for sure, because people want to do their life wheel, their Project Me life wheel check-in, and then it slips through the cracks. And this is a once a month, first week of the month, you're going to be doing that for sure. And then you can report back into the group and say which life area you want to give some focus. It's up to the individual how much they want to be involved in the group and be sharing, or whether it's just having that prompt, whether it's just that's what they need, is the prompt to do it. And then the action sheets right there, really easily to print out. So if you're having a challenge, you print out the challenge solver action sheet. I very much want Project We to be that you're becoming the expert of yourself. So it's not about running around and asking everybody else what you should do. It's very much empowering you to become the project manager of your life and the expert of you, like be your own guru. So when people are, you know, saying I'm challenged in this, it'll be great if somebody's got some links or some resources, but it's not about anybody telling anybody else what they should do, because there's no cookie cutter template for how we should live our life. And we all have different values, and we all have different things that are important to us at different times in our life. And so it's going to be a supportive community, but it's about supporting people to figure out their own action steps. You know, so I've got lots of tools and strategies to help us help each other.
Oh, I just love this so much. I mean, everyone needs this. I mean, really, because I think that I just feel like that time of stepping back and reflecting is what's missing. I know for me, just sometimes I just like want to take my journal out. I try to journal every day a little bit, and I have a bullet journal where I kind of list out goals and what I want to focus on and that kind of thing. But just, I don't do it like exactly regularly. Like I don't do it every month. It's just like, I kind of pull the thing out. I'm like, ooh, I need to look back at what I was trying to do this year or this quarter or whatever. So I love that accountability piece. And oh, I'm for sure going to do it, because how fun. I love this. And I just know that I have a busy year coming up. So being able to kind of parse out like what should be my focus right now. And I love how in the Project Me book, you really say, don't try to do everything at the same time. And that is really important too, because I tend to be an extremist where I'm like, okay, I'm going to change all my habits this month. You know, I'm going to suddenly only eat vegetables, and I'm going to run every day, and I'm going to talk to each of my children for 10 minutes every day. Focus. You know, I go way overboard. And then of course I feel like a failure because I don't do it all. So I love, why don't you talk a little bit, just for people who don't know, what are the parts of the wheel, and what is your philosophy about kind of that focusing in on just one thing at a time?
Sure. Yeah. Really good point. I'm so glad that you brought that up, because in the welcome video for Project We, I really want to rein people in, because you can get super excited when you're like, whoa, I'm going to change my whole life. And so my welcome video is very much going to be touching on, hey, you can do anything, but not everything all at once. Yep. And so it's going to be about looking at which areas of your life need some focus first to get the foundation well made, because when you have a firm foundation beneath you, that's when you can progress and, you know, you can move into other areas. So for some people, I'm going to go through the eight areas on the life wheel like you suggested. So we've got productivity and time management, which is a real foundation point for a lot of people. I'm not going to be saying these in any order, because it's up to everybody where they start, but I do tend to find that a lot of women want to start with their productivity and time management, because when they get those skills under their belt and things are calmer, that's when they have the mental bandwidth and the time to be able to focus on some of the other areas. Another area is family, and that is anything to do with, you know, your family, either your kids or extended family members. It doesn't include a partner, because there's a separate area for that, and that's love. And love is for a partner, and that, and there's no, if you're currently with a partner or whether you're single, it's just looking at that area of your life and seeing what could use some focus. Then we have the health and well-being area of your life. And then there is work. And work, even for people who don't work, we put in there, if you volunteer, if you're on a committee, if you're thinking about work, if you're feeling frustrated that you're not working, if you are super happy that you're not working and you feel fulfilled in all areas of your life, then you just, you know, skip that area. You mark it a 10 and you move on. And then there's fun and friendships, which is so important. And I absolutely loved the interview, the podcast interview that you did with Shasta. Is it Shasta Nelson?
Yes.
Yeah, she is amazing. And she's a resource in my book in the fun and friendships area. Because for a lot of women, I hear that the fun is kind of dried up. They're kind of like robots getting up every day and doing everything that needs to be done and then falling into bed every night and then waking up the next day and doing it all again. And when your life feels like that, life's got no juice. You know, you're just, it's just not a good thing. So one of the really important areas of the Project Me Life Will is fun and friendships and making sure that you've got some hobbies and some interest and some that sort of thing in your life to make sure that it doesn't feel boring every day. And then two more, money and finances, keeping an eye on that, and personal growth. And personal growth is like the area that I never had time for before, because I was always so busy. So I would kind of look at personal growth. And if I'd just done a yoga class that month, I'd be like, well, that was good. And if I'd just done like one small, like a little mini course on something, that would be good. And it wasn't until I got the rest of my life into a firm foundation that suddenly I had time to meditate every morning, waking up before the kids get up and meditating every morning and doing workshops and doing all sorts of things. Like now personal growth feels like the biggest feature of my life, and everything else kind of falls into place because I'm in such a great place energetically and vibrationally and all of that. So that's one of the things that we're going to be working on a lot with Project We, is how to make sure that you give that area of your life the attention it needs, because when you work on that part of your life, you're suddenly living your life with flow and intention, and all the stuff that you were bogged down with before kind of just falls by the wayside and you handle it so much better.
Oh, I just love that. So let's talk about a little bit about fun and friendship. I want to know what you do for that area. Like, what are some of the things, because I know you post sometimes and I get very inspired by you, but what are you working on, or what do you do to enhance that part of your life?
Well, I have to say that the fun and friendships area of my life has never been an area that's been a problem for me. But the other areas, if anything, when I first started my Project Me, what I realized when I was doing my life will check-in every month was that I was marking fun and friendships a 10, because I was seeing so much of my friends and having so much fun and all of that, that other areas of my productivity was a mess. I wasn't getting work done. I wasn't getting to the gym often enough and all of that. So what helped me to be able to look objectively is to go, how can I combine fun with some of the other stuff I need to do? So I started, if I had to go to IKEA, I would ask a friend to come with me, a friend that I needed to see anyway, and we would have Swedish meatballs halfway through the maze. You know what I mean?
Oh, yes, right. Oh, yeah. Fun. Yes.
And if I needed to go to the gym or do a workout, I would go, who's a friend that I could invite to do something with me? We'd go for a run together. And I began looking at how I could still see the friends that I want to see, because I've got such amazing friends, but combine it with doing other things. And I would look at my date nights, and I was having great date nights with my husband. We do that a lot. But I was like, okay, here's another friend I know who we want to see, and we're friends with them as a couple. So let's combine kind of a date night, you know, with these other friends. And I began to find a better balance in my life because I was able to sort of tick the other boxes, but be able to do it with my friends. Now for other people, of course, they're not seeing enough of their friends at all. And again, they could do the combination thing. So yeah, that's a top tip. Friends and fun friendships with other things.
Oh my gosh. I love that. That's so funny. So that was an area that when you probably first did your reel, you were already a 10.
Yeah.
That's interesting. So that's a good clue too, I guess, when you're doing this, like say, for example, like your work is a 10, you're doing really great, but it might be that it's too much of a focus almost, or something like that. That would be another thing that you learn from this.
That's what the check-in does. You're seeing where you're putting so much of your focus at the expense of perhaps something else. And it's then going, in the month ahead, because it's, you're never doing your check-in like for your year ahead. You're doing it for your month ahead. You're reflecting back on your previous month and you're looking at your month ahead, because everything fluctuates all the time. So if you are like, whoa, I've been putting so much focus on my work and at the expense of something else in your life, or your health or your family, then you go, okay, in the month ahead, what am I going to do about that? And that's when you say, all right, I'm going to shut off my computer and not work after this time. I'm going to make weekends be work free, whatever it is, that you can get yourself into a better balance again. And then the following month you do a check-in and you see again, it's this kind of reflecting and check-in that gets you to really clearly see what's working and what's not, so that you can move forward.
Oh, I'm just so excited to do this. So tell me how I can do this with the book. Like, how does it work? Like, can you like be in your book and going to the session?
Yeah, it all
sort of like all goes together.
It all goes together. Yeah, you don't have to have the book to do Project We, but if you've read the book, it'll really, really help you to have that kind of understanding of the concept of it. But no, I want to make it be that the membership login area, really, there'll be a start here, and that will be where all new members start, and that's where you can watch the couple of videos that are there and know how to get started. And from there, that's when you're like, okay, I need to work on my productivity and time management. So you go to that little box, which is color-coded. Just everything's gonna be color-coded. Just
oh my gosh, love it.
So for productivity, it's blue, and you head to the blue productivity box, and that's where you'll find some help and inspiration for how to get the productivity area of your life into a better position.
I feel like this could be a fun thing to sign up for with a friend too, because you could kind of get both. You could have the online learning element. It's sort of like a personal growth thing, but then your friend who's also doing it, maybe you could get together monthly live, you know, for coffee and check in with each other about how you're doing it. I think that's how I would love to do it. Cause I get a little bit like, even with like Shasta has the online like friendship stuff, I feel like I spend too much time on my computer. So I feel like I want to like get content from, like I want to learn and get content, but then I want to connect live with people to really flesh it out. That sort of works
exactly
better for me.
I'm so happy you said that, because it really is this kind of, like I said, it's not just a, here's a formula and you need to follow it. It's all about what you need. If you don't have friends to do this with, then you're going to be able to use the community more for that. And if you've got outside friends that you want to do this together with, then, you know, you can do that. So it really is, you make it your own.
Oh, that's just so great. And okay, so when does it start? Like, when can people join, and what's happening with it?
Well, I wanted it to start ideally on the 1st of January, 2019, because woohoo, you know, that just feels so good. And then I thought about my own life and that I have to walk my talk. And if I am going to get everything all lined up and ready on the 1st and everything, then I would be over the Christmas and New Year period, not with my family, not having fun, not turning off my computer and, you know, everything that I don't want to do over the holidays.
Right.
And so I am definitely going to start it mid-January. So I'm thinking, you know, the 15th, 16th of January. But what I'm going to do is have something all ready for the 1st of January, so that everybody who signs up before, you know, end of the year, then they will automatically on the 1st of January, even though the first monthly payment won't come until mid-January, they're going to get the first video and the first how to get started and that, so that there's something to get stuck into on the 1st for those eager beavers who really want to do something before the 15th. And then from the 15th is when it will all kind of officially open. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that is just so exciting. Okay. Do you know how much it's going to be? And what happens if we're in America?
Yeah. So, by the way, I know, because I'm in the UK and I've been doing this whole, ooh, how do I price things? And everyone says price it in dollars, because people in other parts of the world are used to things being in dollars, but Americans see a pound sign and they go, what does that mean? You know, just like complete, you know, what does that mean? Whereas most of us in other parts of the world will know that $19 is here, I know it's about 15 pounds. You know, I just, we just kind of, we're kind of used to calculating it. So I'm going to make it be, I think it's going to be $19 a month for founder membership. Okay. Because ultimately I want to make it be the dollar a day principle, because I think that's such a great thing, you know, so a dollar a day. And because some months have, you know, different months, it'd probably be $29 a month. and that will be less than a dollar a day, you know, right. that kind right. of concept. So right. founding membership will be 19 locked in.
Wow. That sounds like mm-hmm. a really good deal. Like, I love how you said Netflix for your life.
Yeah. Right. Or like a gym membership for your soul.
Yes. That's so good. I love it so much. Okay. So what other, we talked a little bit about this already, but what else do you want to share about Project We or about that sense of community and support and how that's so essential for our well-being?
Yeah, well, I just feel that, I mean, I've got some quotes here that I'm putting together for the sales page and for the info page. I've got, individually, we are one drop. Together, we are an ocean. And I just love that because it's so true. There's this whole collective energy that happens when we are not just doing things in a vacuum, doing things in a bubble, but when we begin to connect with other people. And did you ever read The Celestian Prophecy way back when? Do you remember
No.
that book? There was this book that became an international bestseller in the mid-90s called The Celestian Prophecy. And it was this fiction book that took place in Peru. And it was, everyone was reading this book and I read it too. It was the first personal development book that I ever read that made me kind of go, wow. And it wasn't billed as a personal development book. It was like this kind of fiction book, but interwoven into it were these 9 insights. And it was all an adventure to find these 9 insights. Well, a few years after I read it, I wrote it off as kid stuff because I started getting more into Deepak Chopra and reading books by the Dalai Lama and really getting into other speakers and all of that. And I wrote The Celestian Prophecy off as kid stuff. And I thought, oh, well, that was just kind of my entry level, you know, getting myself into it, but bah. And then last summer I was on a holiday in Tuscany and on the bookshelf, you know, on a holiday bookshelf, there was The Celestian Prophecy. And I thought, oh, there's that book, The Celestian Prophecy. And I just took it off the shelf and went by the pool and started reading it. And I was like, oh my gosh, all this stuff that I didn't get the first time I read it about connecting and the energy exchange between people when they are exchanging ideas. And there's this whole thing in there that we all belong to different thought groups and that our thought groups merge, bring us together. And that when we start speaking to other people who are in the same thought group as us, we begin sharing our kind of divine downloads, if you will, like stuff that just comes to us. And then we begin really lifting each other higher. Like, I mean, I can't even go into it all right now. I actually wrote a blog post about it that I published last Monday about it. So if you go to myprojectme.com/Celestian Prophecy, you will get to read about some of my insights that have come from rereading The Celestian Prophecy again. And I'm now seeing that we are moving forwards in this way that we are not going to be going it alone. Like the more that it's called the collective consciousness. Mm-hmm. And I've been Googling this concept and finding out that it's a thing. It's a real thing, this collective consciousness. So whilst in the beginning, I want to make Project We very entry level and not too woo-woo for everybody, because I think it's important that we get the foundations of our life into a really firm place. But watch out, because I really think that once we do, we are going to be like moving into what I think is like the next evolution of mankind.
Yeah. Woo! Starting all at Project We. It's all going to start.
Well, I'm not the only one doing this. There's lots of people around the world who are beginning to realize the power of getting together with like-minded people and growing together. Yeah,
absolutely. Oh my gosh, I love it so much. Well, I am super inspired. I am definitely going to participate and be part of your founders.
I'm so excited that you're going to be a part of it. It'll be your energy being in there will just be alone. Like, wow.
I'm really, really excited. Okay. So Kelly, tell people where they can find you. I'll put links, but in case they don't look at the show notes, where's just the easiest place to find you and find out more about joining Project We?
Okay. The easiest way is myprojectme.com. You head there and right away you will see a place to put your email address, and then you get on my Monday Motivator newsletter list, and that is where I'm going to be sharing about Project We founding membership. That's probably the easiest thing you can do. Of course, I'm on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter and all of that, but really that is the easiest action I can tell people.
Okay, amazing. Kelly, thank you so much for being on the podcast. I know we're going to need to do it again because I want to check in partway through this, maybe after a couple months of Project We, after I've been participating. And so maybe in the spring, we'll do another one and just kind of hopefully some other people who listen have joined and we can talk about it. Or maybe I can even get questions from other people and that kind of thing. But I'm just so excited for this and for your work. And I love what you're doing and how much you're helping people with your work. So thank you again for being on.
Thank you so much for having me and letting me share about this.
Thank you for joining me for this episode. I hope you enjoyed my conversation with Kelly. As always, you can find notes, links, and further information about everything we talked about at my website at sunshine-parenting.com. Just search for episode 67. While you're there, I invite you to join my email list. Each week, I send out an email with my most recent podcast episode, blog post, as well as articles and information that I think will help all of us raise a generation of kids who become thriving adults. This week's iTunes review comes from Rada over in Serbia. She says, "It's great. You are a wonderful person and you mean a lot to all of us who are engaged in children and camping." Thank you so much, Rada, for taking the time to give Sunshine Parenting a rating and a review in iTunes. I really appreciate your support for all of these years of both my podcast and my blog posts. As of this recording, I am grateful to have 43 reviews in iTunes. Thank you so much to all of you who've taken the time to give me a review. It means a lot to me. I'll end this episode with one of my favorite quotes for this time of year. It comes from Sydney Harris. "The best thing you can give your children, next to good habits, are good memories."
This podcast is a proud member of Parents on Demand, a network of high-quality shows for families just like yours. Download our free network app on Apple and Android and listen to your favorite episodes on the go.